Hey guys, Kinway here, with another video to commentate. I have a volunteer from one of our member in IDV 101 server in Discord, another Texan. He's an excellent Robbie player, so let's get into it. So it's Robbie playing against Explorer, Forward, Gravekeeper, Mercenary in Arms Factory, spawning in the middle. Let's see, okay, sweeping towards Shack is alright. Tinnitus trigger, but I don't think I have to go towards the shack corner. So okay, there should be one behind the shack cipher here. Oh, there's one purple flame out there already. Okay, this is an excellent corner to hunt for survival, because this is the edge of the map, and there's an excellent snipe on mercenary, and that's very good. Forcing mercenary to face his elbow pad and rendering him more difficult to rescue from. Placing a tree here. Couldn't see what trait he brought, but it's on cooldown, and going to tree pallet, still chasing on mercenary. Not sure if it's a good idea, but is he really planning to down the mercenary? Okay, probably not. Looking for another, the quality gauge. Wait, hold on. Okay, that's better. Okay, sandbag, there's still nobody here. Plucking a tree is important. Oh, okay, so he brought blink. That's new to me, because usually, as I am aware, he brings people, so maybe it's a change. And that is Gravekeeper, utilizing a pallet a bit early for my liking, out of corrupt zone, and there's a purple flame. Not yet, now. Okay, managed to avoid. Wrong side of the pallet. Oh no, that's a miss hit. Okay, just gotta keep calm. But sometimes that happens, and it's very important to maintain your composure. And okay, that's actually not a bad move from Gravekeeper, because potentially that's a blink, and he probably read that the blink is incoming. Okay, nice charge attack into the pallet, and preventing a pallet stun post hit. Now there's a purple flame in factory ruins. Okay, maintaining a clear sight. Missed it. Still alright. Oh no. Fail blink. So in a bad position here on the second shovel. Okay, seems that the heal up mercenary, and there's a pallet here forcing a break, and Gravekeeper could safely transition into the small pallet and then back into factory. Oh, but he decided to round here. Okay, because there's two pallets used up here, and he seems to go into no man's land with a pallet here. Not necessarily a good move, because shovel is running out soon already, and he's cornering himself by going to this corner and forcing an attack. Fourth hit. Still no full presence. Cyphers is actually two cyphers down, because as an explorer, probably digging for pitch. Okay, that's not necessarily a good way to use the flame, because if you use a flame, you preferably to zoom over to hit rather than using it to break the pallet. Okay, well, two of the more important pallets are being used already. Still on to Gravekeeper. Gravekeeper having a new knee-jerk reaction. No. Okay, that's a few flame too many to miss. Okay, this restful road should be able to catch. And now. Okay. Checking around, I guess. Nobody. Okay, yes. Don't go through the pallet. Oh! Nice. That was very close. Almost a balloon rescue from forward, but forward, but charge is almost up. Oh, he missed. Oh my god. That's a misplay. That's a heavily misplay from forward. And you could, yes, just. Oh, Explorer, what are you doing? Oh no. Okay, don't get greedy. Yes. The problem is, I'm not sure if Cypher is prime, and potentially it is. Okay, but there's no one at the Cypher, because Mercenary is there. And the last Cyphers, if you can see, it's all at three spots there. So definitely, it's not Cypher, even if Cypher prime, there's no one at the Cypher yet.
Okay, now forward can almost pick himself up. Okay, nice, forcing an early save because double hit already. I would have gone to forward, to be honest. That's a miss. Okay, this is a hit for sure. Oh, forward! Oh my god. Okay, forward, that's an excellent play. Okay, that bought Gravekeeper some other time because otherwise he's down and dead on chair already. And here is still up for everybody's grab. Because Cypher most probably is primed. Oh, that's an excellent hit on Explorer. Okay, I think it's game over now. I think it's game over. There's another purple flame there. There's a purple flame there. Indicating Gravekeeper should be nearby. Yep. No, now! Yes. Oh gosh. Still not game over because Explorer will be able to self-pick up. Gravekeeper there on chair. Mercenary will take quite a while to wake up. Took like 4 hits, I think. Yep. Teleport back to the chair because Explorer picked up already, yes, as expected. Okay, now, okay, as we can see, the game is still not out of the bag yet. Okay, because yes, they will be priming the Cypher and popped it too early for my liking. Because could have waited for the Hunter to hit, because both of them actually are still capable to take one hit. Explorer will be quite messy here to handle. There's no more pallets here, so it's a very dangerous place. Oh, I could have gone over to 2 containers actually. Okay, there's this last pallet to protect him. And if he transition into factory, it will be game over. I don't think that's the right play. And this should be an easy down. Yes, planting the tree. No, don't go for mercenary. That's a decoy. Now, Explorer is very difficult to find already. Because Trail lost quickly, one thing. Second thing is that he can go into mini mode. He can go into mini mode. And that's very difficult to find. As you can see here, couldn't find Explorer already. But, okay, there's a purple flame. No. That's Mercenary's purple flame. Let's hope Dungeon is not there. I'm not too sure if Dungeon is over there. Although it's one of the spawn, but probably not. Let's see if there's the crow reappears. Okay, no. Okay, we saw some trail. And he should be able to see purple flame once he step out of the corrupt zone. Which is not yet. Now. Okay, vaulted. Can't tell for sure. There is what? Okay, it's just a matter of time now because the dungeon is not over here. And basically, Explorer is just wasting time for detention. Okay, that's game over. And round you go, but there's no escape from here. There's practically no escape from Robbie once he reached this stage that plant a tree. And you are trapped here within the containers and hit. Oh no. Not yet. But, I mean, it's just a matter of time here. Nice. Easy hit. Easy down. It's one of the game that I would say, yes. It's one of the classic game where the blunder pull by forward. Missing the stun is one thing. Missing the stun during chair animation, that's another thing, and that's a very big mistake. But playing as Hunter, it just happens sometimes that I just think you need to capitalize on the mistake, and I think Texan did very well here. So thanks for the game, hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys around.
Alright guys, Kinwai here with another gameplay to commentate by another volunteer. He sent me quite a number of Dream Witch gameplays, and I absolutely would love to analyze Dream Witch. One is that I'm by no means a Dream Witch main, but of course Dream Witch is being one of the S tier hunters is definitely very very interesting to try to get into the mind of the pilot. Okay, so let's get into it. Oh, I think yeah, he did say that due to his recording there's no sound, but I think it should be fine.
Okay, for Arms Factory spawn at near shack, going to the shack corner will be a good sweep because this is one of the weaker corners. Okay, so let's try to see if he try to Terror Shock or plan for a leech. Seems like he's gonna okay, we'll call for a leech, and this should able to sandwich it. Okay, nice. That's a very nice early hit. Okay, so that moving the follower out of reach, so that could auto home on prospector. So prospector vaulted and try to head towards tree pallet. This should be able to. Oh, I think that's okay. Unlucky. Otherwise, normally that's a quite a free hit already because of the attract. Okay, we'll try to go into factory. Okay, this E. Okay, that's weird. Okay, that's a nice, very nice down. We try to see, try to sandwich a play there. So perfumer is nearby. Let's see what the perfumer will try to do. Maybe try to heal up, or what? In fact, there's two plays heal up. Okay, not an ideal situation because this would actually give the hunter some free hits. Okay, going through to basement, is it? Yes, basement. Nice. Basement, is there any priestess around? Painter, prospector, barmaid, perfumer. Okay, there's no priestess, so that should be a quite a secure what you call that camp. We only have one. We only have one leech outside, so effectively there's only two little girls. Okay, this one need to be positioned for patrolling around. Oh, actually there's three. Okay, nice. There's one on prospector and there's another on painter. One thing is that can't exactly tell which leech is he controlling. Seems like he found another person to leech onto, which is perfumer. Then this is not a very nice tempo for the Dream Witch because effectively he has four little girls to control around, and that exerts a lot of map pressure. Okay, no problem. I think prospector will be going to the manor. Despite that, there's still two, three ciphers remaining, so it's not really in the back yet for Dream Witch, but here we see Barmaid being hit. But Barmaid is not an easy target for Dream Witch because of her drink, and if the Barmaid has a broken window, she could very easily be a three hit target. So as we see here, I think he's foregoing Barmaid. I'm not too sure, but Barmaid is quite a bad target. Another thing about Dream Witch, right? Because you have to maintain a good map pressure by multitasking and exerting your map pressure here and there. So by we see here, right, that he's no longer tunneling on Barmaid is actually a very good move. Because one of the key strength of Dream Witch, you keep everybody busy. You keep everybody busy. So as here we see that Perfumer is already aware. So never mind, as long as able to keep her away. But we see the condition right now is on the last cipher already. Not the best of situation because we see Dream Witch have yet to be on the full presence. Nonetheless, it's not really game over yet because for late game Dream Witch is really powerful with the detention times the number of little girls that she has. Oh no, it's two ciphers. Okay, sorry. Because of the resolution, I couldn't see properly. Chasing perfumer here. Perfumer actually has a leech on her. Okay, she picked up the. Going to factory. Okay, there's a perfume. Oh, she brought blink. Okay, I think this is the first time that I see. I think perfume is almost up. Yep. Don't walt. Okay, she didn't walt. Oops, don't. Yep. Oh no, I think she stumbled a bit with the slow walk. Nonetheless, I'm not sure if she has broken window, but definitely has ninja reaction because we saw a speed boost there. Let's see. I can't see properly whether it's two or one cipher. One cipher? Yeah, one cipher remaining. So Dream pilot correctly identified to forgo the target. I can't hear the progress. Okay, there's two dual decoding here. So definitely a good target to lock onto. We have Painter and Barmaid. And okay, one hit on Painter, and Painter has a leech on him, so that's also good. Perfumer has one as well. Checking on Perfumer's location right now, which I can't see. Okay, that was a miss. Okay, but never mind that the leech managed to get rid of her. Also because Perfumer have a natural 30% heal debuff, so that's gonna be quite a while to heal up. Typically about 26 seconds, if I'm not mistaken. And that would able to buy Dreamwish quite a bit of time. Let's see what's gonna happen right now. Okay, fine. They're gonna decide to leech Perfumer and probably chair her, which I think is still alright because the cipher, as we've seen earlier, is I'm not sure of the sound, but because we're in spectator mode, we're able to see the progress earlier, like about 60%. So 60% with dual decoding, it'll take about let's see, 40% left, about typically 20 seconds. 20 seconds. So there's someone inside there who's just walking casually, and it should be Barmaid. If she's here, I think probably Cypher. I'm not sure if Cypher is prime or not, because they healed up. So that should. Oh my god, why on Barmaid? Okay, that's kind of weird. Because of a hit on Barmaid. Okay, Cypher is obviously not prime because he didn't go pop yet. Okay, now the good thing is that Perfumer has a leech target. Okay, so the leech would be able to know the location, which she already know. But deleting is in progress. Eh, how come she didn't leech? Okay, now this is the precarious situation because I think Cypher should be pretty much prime right now. And she has to hit and up. Yep. And now it's where the end game begins. Oh gosh, oh gosh. So during the borrowed time, right, because every survivor will be running at full speed, right? It's very, very important to not lose focus. And this is where I think the pilot did very well in securing the kill with Perfumer. Okay, so that's a easy one. And we have Barmaid, Sleech following her, and she will have full vision. No, that didn't hit. Okay, this should be a hit. No, that's a good juke. Okay, but surely this time, yep. And that's down on the Barmaid, which I think is around the sandbag area, sandbag or factory ruins. Okay, nice. She located. So one of the another important point of playing Dreamwish, right, is also because if you leech your use your leech to hit your target, right, and then you lose the leech immediately. So I felt it's a very good overall, very good gameplay, on the Dreamwish part. So looking forward to watch more video from this guy Spider. So until next time, see you guys.